Hi, my name is Derek Chin, and I take care of the electronics segment. KUKA recently launched the second generation of Cobot, the LBR EZ, and there are three models, 3kg, 11, and 15kg.
The highlights of the LBR EZ. It has high safety, as each of the six axes contains a dual-channel torque sensor. The hand guiding of the LBR EZ is very smooth. It is best in its class, and precise hand guiding can be carried out with just one hand. Ease of use. The new iKUKA operating system is designed to be easy to use. It makes automation easy for everyone, from robotics expert to beginner. High durability. The LBR EZ mechanics is derived from industrial robot components, such as motor, therefore making it highly durable. The LBR EZ is so fast that as it is industrial robot that can also be collaborative.
Today, I'm going to show you a demonstration of the LBR EZ. And in this demonstration, we will cover three areas: the mastering, the brake test, and finally the programming. By the end of the demonstration, you'll be able to set up and create a simple robot program for the LBR EZ. Let's begin. We will start by performing the mastering. Mastering is the process of setting mechanical zero reference position for each axis. To complete mastering on the LBR EZ, there are three steps involved. First, the mastering itself, then followed by mastering validation. This is to ensure the mastering is done correctly. And finally, the torque mastering validation. And this is to confirm all the torque sensors are in good condition. To perform mastering, we go to setup, select mastering, and press on the master all axis. Okay. You have to ensure that all the axes have to turn green, the indicator. To achieve this, you press on the move to post button. Okay. And follow the instructions on the screen. Okay. When it's done, press on the next button and follow the instructions. Okay, now we have completed the mastering process. Next, we will apply the mastering by clicking on the apply mastering button. Again the same, follow the instructions on the screen. Okay, there we go. We have just completed the mastering and mastering approval process. Next, we will move on to the torque mastering approval process. To perform torque mastering approval, you have to press on the approve all torque button. Okay. And then on the indicator, it will show you that all the axes are currently not at the green position. So you have to move the individual axes to ensure they turn to green. And to do this, you press on the individual axis. When it's done, all the indicator for the axis will turn green. Then what you need to do next is just to press the next button. Okay, and then follow the instructions on the screen. And now, we have completed the top mastering approval process. Next, we move on to perform brick tests. And the purpose of the brick test is to test the brick condition of the axis of each motor. And to do that, we go to setup and select brick test and press on test all bricks. Okay. Follow the instructions on the screen. Okay, we have completed the brick test process. And now we'll create a simple program to pick a block from this location and drop it into this hole. Okay. So then I'll need to move the LBR down to the positions. To achieve this program, we will need to teach four positions. A pre-pick position, pick position, a pre-release position, and finally, the release position.
Now, let's create the program. We start by clicking on the new program button and give it a name. Let's call it pick block. And click on the Add button. Before we proceed to create the program, let's go through the command that are available in the program. To do this, click on the cross sign. All these are the commands or notes that you will find under the basic note palette section. More commands will come in the near future. Let's go through one by one, starting from the top. Sequence. The sequence command is similar to the files in the folder system, and it is used to structure the program. Loop. A loop repeats all the child notes in the specific order until a condition is met. Wait. With this command, the program pauses until a condition is met. Move. There are four types of moves: PTP, linear, circle, and spline. Release. This command will trigger the gripper to open. If else, this command is used to program the simplest form of a branch. If a specific condition is fulfilled, then all notes under the if condition are executed. Otherwise, they are skipped and the program is resumed at the next note. Set. This command will set the value of a signal to true or false. Motion group. The motion group command defines the motion type, which could either be Cartesian or PTP. And finally, the grip command. This command will trigger the gripper to close. In iKUKA, the program structure are arranged in hierarchy, parent-child model. We will start by creating the first position, which is the pre-pick. And to do this, we create a motion group by clicking on the cross sign and click on motion group. When a motion group is used, a move node will automatically be created. Please note that motion group can only contain move nodes as children. Now let's give the motion group a name. Let's say pick. Let's leave the motion type as Cartesian for now. And then we go to move and give it a name. Let's call this pre-pick. As for the motion type, select linear, and the frame, we choose new unshare frame. As for the frame coordinates, we will leave the numbers here as it is, as we will touch up them later. Now, let's proceed to create the second move, which is the pick position. We select move, give it a name. Let's call this pick. For the move type, we choose linear, which is similar. As for the frame, we choose new unshare frame. Again, the same for the frame coordinates, we will touch up them later. Okay. Now, after the robot come to the pick position, the next thing that we wanted to do is to grip the block. And to do this, we create a grip node. Click on the grip node and give it a name. Let's call this grip block. Then we create the third position, which is the pre-release. Again, we select the motion group. Let's give it a name, place. We keep back the motion type as same, Cartesian. Click on the move and give it a new name. Let's call it pre-release. Again, we use linear for the move type. As for the frame, we keep back to the same new unshare frame. The frame coordinates are the same. We keep it as it is, as we will touch up them later. Now, we will then need to create the final position, which is the release position. And to do that, we choose the move. Give it a new name. Let's call it release. Okay. Similar, we choose linear and new unshared frame. Okay. Now, after the robot arrives at the release position, we will need to release the gripper. So to do that, we choose the release node. Give it a name. We have now completed the program, and it consists of four positions: pre-pick, pick, pre-release, and release, and also two gripper actions, close and open. So the next thing that is left to do is to touch up these four positions.
Now, let's start by teaching the first pre-pick position. Okay, this is a good position. Now, I'll touch up this position. Okay, and now the second position, the pick position. Okay, this seems to be a good position. And now, I will touch up this position. And now, we move on to teach the pre-release position. Okay, I will touch up this position. And finally, we will teach the last, the release position. Okay. I'll touch up this position. We have completed the program. Now, let's test it out. Yes. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you have learned how to operate and program the LBR iisy. Thank you.
Industrial intelligence.